Is nutritional yeast healthy? Short answer, there are certainly better options. But let's get into the long answer. So there are many strains of yeast, just like there are many strains of bacteria in our environment, in our food, in our microbiome. Nutritional yeast is the specific strain Saccharomyces cerevisiae. So they take this yeast and they grow it on a cheap sugar source, such as molasses. The yeast is then deactivated with heat, harvested, washed, dried, crumbled, and packaged for distribution. So, you know, we can already say that nutrition is compromised with that much processing. You know, by heating the product, you know, we remove the raw elements to it, the digestive enzyme benefits, you know, the probiotic properties, any beneficial bacteria, the antiscorbutic properties, the vitamin C. What's left is a small amount of vitamins and minerals that were produced by the yeast as they grew. I'm sure some of you guys that have purchased probiotic supplements know that they have to stay refrigerated or the bacteria will die. You know, with nutritional yeast, you're basically buying a dead probiotic. So that would be called an unfortified nutritional yeast. They have to add vitamins to it. And then we have the fortified nutritional yeast that has synthetic vitamins added. That boosts the nutrient content. That is what most people are selling and most people are referring to. You know, if you go online and buy nutritional yeast, that's what you're getting. It's actually pretty difficult to find an unfortified version. These synthetic vitamins that are added to the yeast are highly processed with various chemicals and factories. Plus, if you're adding 10, 15, 20 different vitamins to something, each of those vitamins needs to be sourced from something. Is that source contaminated, polluted? Is it organic? Then these vitamins aren't even bioavailable. You know, what the body easily absorbs. And in some cases, they cause adverse effects due to their unnatural forms and artificial doses. This leaves us with the unfortified version of this yeast product. In this heated, dried form, you know, the yeast will have some B vitamins, minerals, trace minerals, as well as amino acids. On paper, this is an insignificant amount of nutrients, even if you were to eat unrealistic quantities, say half a cup to a cupful of nutritional yeast. And we know there's some nut job out there that's probably doing that right now, and they might be a vegan. So the one or two tablespoons that most people are consuming, I don't think it's going to make a difference. In the context of a natural food, you know, such a small amount is not usually conducive to nutrition. I would be surprised if people had a positive response to consuming this type of supplement. You know, assumingly it would be, an allergic reaction. Maybe you're getting some alertness, you know, especially histamine intolerance. I don't think the amount of nutrients in a tablespoon of this stuff can fix a deficiency of any sort. So whether or not you feel a difference in taking this, there are certainly better alternatives. What we have here is a fermented food, and fermented foods provide our body with very important bioavailable nutrients, you know, broken down amino acids, vitamin K2, probiotic bacteria, things that are crucial for microbiome health, as well as the added bonus of the nutrients inherent to the food. But since this yeast is heated and dried, we remove the bacteria benefits, some of the benefits of fermenting the food. And since it's not an animal product, you know, it has no significant amount of vitamin K2. Kefir, even yogurt to a lesser degree, is a vastly superior option to nutritional yeast. In kefir, you get the broken down amino acids, way more B vitamins, vitamin K2, all of the other fat-soluble vitamins as well, plenty of minerals, potassium, calcium, zinc, magnesium. More importantly, it's a raw product. It will digest easier, maintain its probiotic benefits, and, you know, everything's intact as it's naturally supposed to be. You know, that nutritional yeast, even if you were to consume it raw, it's only one strain of yeast, whereas kefir or yogurt has a symbiotic culture of those bacteria and yeast that will replenish your gut microbiome. That is, if it's the correct type of product. And this isn't to say that, you know, fermented animal foods are always superior. You know, many indigenous groups made a variety of plant food preparations, but they certainly did not heat and dry their product after fermenting it. You know, for instance, making a natural beer is a great example of something healthier than nutritional yeast. Even though it has a slight alcohol content, you know, beer from heirloom organic grains fermented naturally will have superior nutrients and probiotics in comparison to nutritional yeast or, you know, a regular pasteurized beer. You know, we've taken a step away from natural food preparation, natural food quality. You know, looking at animal foods as bad or plant foods as bad, whether you're, you know, vegan or carnivore, ooh-wee! That's not the problem. The problem is the soil quality, what we're spraying on the crops, the negative aspects. All right, Frank, we get it. You don't like nutritional yeast. So what's the solution? Well, if you think you're lacking B vitamins, you can definitely try a B100 vitamin supplement. See if you feel any different, you know, more energy. If you think you're lacking probiotic bacteria, you know, try incorporating some of those fermented foods, perhaps even adding carbohydrates to your diet to feed your microbiome. You know, you can also throw in a vitamin K2 supplement, as you're likely deficient, and that is incredibly hard to get through food. You know, something we constantly have to revisit is that people are making money off of certain products and therefore inflating the benefits of said product. And hey, I think that's great if the product actually works, even if you exaggerate a little bit. But in the case of something like this, and I guess with the majority of things, I can't recommend nutritional yeast with my understanding of nutrition and health. I would go as far as to say, you know, all of these people selling anything are being somewhat disingenuous. And the video I did yesterday, you know, explaining all of my supplement products, you know, how they work, I have corresponding 15 to 20 minute videos on the science, you know, years before I even, you know, brought these products to market, that I had them in mind to sell them. You know, make sure that when you're buying a product, when you're buying a supplement, what's in it? Are you getting that in another source in your diet? If you are, okay, you don't need the supplement. If you're not getting it in your diet, then you have to say, okay, is it actually beneficial? In the case of nutritional yeast, you know, people are getting those nutrients from other foods, and there's vastly superior foods to that. So thank you guys for joining me. Of course, if you can like the video, definitely leave a comment below, helps me out. Of course, if you aren't subscribed, you know, definitely do so and hit that bell icon. If you guys want to support me further, you know, I mentioned organsupplements.com. You can also go to Frankie's Free Range Meat for high quality, nutrient dense animal foods at the most affordable price online. You can check out Frankie's Naturals for minimal ingredients, minimally processed hygiene and cosmetic products, as well as frank-stefano.com for a free carnivore diet meal plan. Thanks again for joining me, guys. Enjoy the rest of your night.